बॉलीवुड एक्ट्रेस सोनाली बेंद्रे न्यूयॉर्क से कैंसर का ट्रीटमेंट करवाकर भारत वापस लौट आई हैं
और अपनी नॉर्मल लाइफ जी रही हैं। हाल ही में 5th इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस के दौरान स्पॉट हुई सोनाली ने एक बार फिर अपना दुख व्यक्त किया।
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी, इट्स अ प्लेजर टू बी हियर। डॉक्टर पाटनकर, डॉक्टर पाटकर एंड डॉक्टर अग्रवाल, देव बीन स्ट्रॉन्ग पिलर्स इन दिस जर्नी ऑफ माइन एंड somewhere have been part of the beginning of this phase of my life, I would say, because it is a different phase. And my husband and me joke, we say BC and AC, that's before cancer and after cancer. It's like a different lifetime. Like you said, that you know, I don't think I'm a champion in the sense of kind of trying to. My voice is much softer than what was going on before. I'm not here. Sorry about that. I can't really shout so much, but you are right about it, that we need to demand. And what happened was that I did not look at what was happening to me and did not ask too many questions as I should have. Couple of points to that. Probably it comes from the fact that as women, without knowing in the subconscious, we are all taught sahan shakti bahut achhi baat hoti hai. So you're taught that, you know what, be tough, bear the pain. You have to bear a child, bear the pain. We are all being told that somewhere. So you kind of internalize that and you're always thinking that, you know what, I can bear the pain and you can go on. And I kept telling myself that I'm putting in an 18-hour day. So obviously I'm fine, I'm not dying, but I was. And then I look back and I say, how did I do that? So then the question was that, why did I put up with this pain? What was I waiting for me to collapse? To understand what my body was trying to tell me. So it comes down to that the body was sending me signals. I was not looking at it as I should have looked at it. Half of the time we say that, yeah, but I've told my doctor, so it should be okay. But we forget doctors are human beings too. And they're looking at, especially in our country, the kind of patients they're looking at, the kind of numbers they're looking at. It's really not possible for them, you know, to blame everything on doctors and say, why did they not? I mean, how can they? It's my own body which was telling me and I did not listen to it. So why expect somebody else to? So I think we are already putting on a lot of burden where doctors are concerned. So that's where it started for me, not listening to the signals. Went in for a TCRE procedure. Because these are the medical terms that I know of and which here, this room, people will understand. But and we were suddenly... We discovered that there was something in there which was causing this whole thing all this while. And we came out of there and then we discovered that it was not just there, it was all over. It was spreading really fast and it had spread to a lot of areas and basically it was the 4th stage. So I don't know how I had pulled it off till then, but that was the shocker. My husband was very clear about it. He said, I don't want to take any chances. And the reason I think what, I mean, I was literally fighting with him. I'm like, my child is young, the womb is here, and you know, we're just picking up. And it was literally in 2 days after the diagnosis that we had packed our bags and we had left. And I didn't know when I was coming back, what was happening, where I was going for. It was just the two of us. We had not really had time to discuss it with too many people and we had just taken off. He had got the appointments and we had just taken off. So I kept fighting with him, saying that, you know, how can you just stop everything? But when I reached there and I got to know the extent of this, somewhere I did honestly feel, thank God I'm here. I think that comes from the fact that there are a lot of things that now in hindsight I look at, and it was probably an instinct, but where he came from, and as he explains it to me, he said that, you know, I know we would have got great care here, and touch wood, we have the means to, and the connections to, and the relationships where we could. Tap on people, but the fact remains that we went to a place where this is what they dealt with. The only disease they dealt with was this. So his logic was that if for so many years they're only dealing with cancer and its various types of cancers, so much so that the place that I went to, the entire building was dedicated to just these type of cancers. That means there has to be something in which, when you're obviously doing it constantly for so many hours, there's definitely going to be more data that's collected, there's going to be more intuition that is going to be there. He said, you were at the stage, but I did not want to take a chance on this. And what, like in his words, what he said was that, I would rather say that, oh, I, overthought it and I overreacted rather than later on feel that I should have done it. He said, I did not want to take that chance. And that was the reason why we went there. So, no offense. And my journey has been that eventually what I have understood, and to put it down in layman terms, is that early detection is what is the most important thing where this disease is concerned. Because medicine is at a stage where if you detect it early, there needn't be such invasive treatments that we have to go through. Because sometimes, right now, I think the disease is somewhat less scarier than the treatment that you go through. The treatment is actually more frightening and more painful. You feel that sometimes. So early detection, I think, is what is the most important thing. Had I detected it early, there were more chances. It would cost me less. I would go through less painful treatments. I would have more options in where the treatment was concerned also. So for me, I didn't know this disease was so prevalent because nobody talks about it. When it happened to me, I realized in my family how many people had had it and had not spoken about it. And I was like, I wish I knew. I wouldn't have thought that, oh, this is never going to happen to me. So when I put the post out on my social media, because I was doing some work, I did not want any kind of a gossip around it. And my son, children are much more tech savvy. I didn't want him hearing and reading something wrong. So I wanted to put out my story myself. So when I put it out, the response that I got was what was shocking for me. Because there were people from all stratas of society writing in to me saying, this is what happened to my aunt, to my grandmother, to my son, to my mom. Everybody, and there was no like a niche in society. Every strata of society they were writing in from and they were discussing it. And suddenly I said, oh, but if this has been so prevalent, why had I not heard of it? And I never knew that this could happen, that it is so rampant. I know we all say that today the pollution, the toxins and etc. Of course, they must be affecting it and they are there. But cancer is something that's been there for the longest time. Probably it was not diagnosed as often. But when so many stories you hear when they talk about their grandmothers and their grandaunts getting it, surviving it or not surviving it, either ways. So obviously it's been around for a long time, probably it's getting diagnosed better now. But what I realized was that this was something that they were all holding on to and nobody shared it in their own families. Like there was a mother who told me that, my son went through it, I did not share it with my own mother because, we kept it hidden, we said it was asthma. I was like, what? Why would you do that? And it's like, no, how can you share this with people? I'm like, why would you not share it with people? What I realized by sharing was that first I heard that I was not alone, that this was not so unique, I was not so special that only I had got cancer. Everybody gets it and anybody could get it. Secondly, everybody kept saying that how could you get it? You are so healthy, your lifestyle is so good, how could you get it? And I kept asking myself that question, that why have I got it? And then I realized it's genes, it's not something that definitely if you have the genetic predisposition to it or whatever, your toxins and the environment and the way you lead your life will definitely affect. That will affect for any other illness also. Leading a healthy life is a basic thing for any sort of disease, not just for cancer.
बॉलीवुड की अपडेट्स और गॉसिप न्यूज के लिए मायापुरी कट सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें और हमारे अपडेट्स जानने के लिए बेल आइकन जरूर प्रेस करें।